I've been compared to Eloise, who grew up at the plaza, as based on Liza Minnelli, or so some say. But my family came from overseas with names like Cohen and Maza, and built the South's first kosher deli. Grandma Mary and Grandpa Ben moved from south to north, buying a famed hotel, then lived there. The years passed, and I came forth with quite a unique legacy. Just a little New York kid growing up at the Algonquin, seeing sights like few kids did growing up at the Algonquin, visiting Granny and Grandpa each week, staying for a show. I talk to Harpo and also speak to friends like Lerner and Lowe. Dad would drive us, and what fun showing up at the Algonquin. Me, the cute and carsick one, throwing up at the Algonquin. But this klutz who classmates teased, last picked on a teen, found that back at the Algonquin, life was like a dream. Like the evening Grandpa complained about all the noise on the floor below him keeping him up. It was Lerner and Lowe writing, "I could have danced all night." Or the afternoon when Granny was flashed on the corner by Marilyn Monroe. "You think this mink is something, Mrs. Bodney? You should see what's underneath." I wish I'd been invited over that day. Broadway actors by the bunch lined the lobby, a whole chorus. Iggy Wolfington. And at my bar mitzvah lunch, Oscar Peterson played for us. "This Is True" sang along with Ella Fitzgerald, not Mitch, and kissed Terry Moore, my crush from Muddy Joe Young, called Agnes Moorehead the mean old witch, and heard Olivier snore. Saw the Red Graves and the Lunts, Marlena Dietrich without makeup. I was too young for her then. Brendan being sober once. Noel Coward once he'd wake up after a marvelous party. Most have checked in with St. Pete. Still, they were supreme. Growing up at the Algonquin, life was like a dream. Granny said, "Come spend the night. Plenty to eat, plenty to see. Stay as long as you like." And I did. After college, when I flew home, room 410 became my new home. Struggling playwright, I was able to retrace the old round table with great spirits residentially. Thurber, Ferber, Walcott, Benchley. Some nights I heard bangs and humming, Dorothy Parker's ghost or plumbing. Then my own shows got rehearsed there with free food till you could burst there. That's how I got such a hot cast. First-rate hungry actors got cast all to the beat on 44th Street. Before I moved on, my grandparents gone. Now and then I still go tiptoeing up to the Algonquin. It's a strange nostalgic trip going up to the Algonquin. Other owners now lay claim changes are extreme. Still, when I'm at the Algonquin, life is like a... Thank you, Grandma and Grandpa, for that sweet dream.